Welcome, Dragon Disciples and Wyvern Warriors, to another episode of Draconis Gold Gaming. I am your host, Draconis Gold, the Golden Dragon, and we are continuing the 7 Days to Die. I'll tell you up front that if you like my video, please hit the like button, and if you enjoy my content, maybe you're new to the channel and you haven't yet, please feel free to subscribe. Your subscriptions let me know that you enjoy what I do, and I do love what I do. So let's get started here. When we last left you, I had gotten over here to the new tower base. I had started working my way around the perimeter, and I finished going all the way around the perimeter here. We have it dug out on all four sides. I need to get rid of this stuff in the middle so that we just kind of get a flat ground here again, and we'll start working our way down. But before I do that, I want to dig down to bedrock. And so I'm probably going to come over to this corner and do that. I am not going to do this on camera because it would just take too dadgum long, and you guys don't want to sit here and watch me just digging down the bedrock. So I'm going to go ahead and dig out a little bit of this here, and then once I've done that, we will start digging down to bedrock, and I will time lapse it, or I will just skip over it depending on how I feel. Time lapse is good sometimes, but sometimes time lapse is just boring. And I think in this case, time-lapse will probably be just boring, so I will be back in a few minutes once I make it down to bedrock. Alright guys, I'm about to head up topside. I have dug down to bedrock. I have actually dug over. What I plan on doing is digging up to about this point here, and then turning east, and then going over to the missile silo. Now I'm going to have to dig down from the missile silo, obviously, also, and dig across to this point so I can kind of interconnect these two. So probably through the night, what I'm going to do is go over here and create myself a couple more picks and start digging down to bedrock underneath the missile silo so that I can get these two connected. And the reason I want to do it this way, where I dig straight north and then I dig to the east, is because if I try and dig at a diagonal this way, I dig about the same amount as I would have to dig by going up here and going to the right. I know it sounds weird, but the way the game is designed, I have to dig it kind of too wide if I go at an angle, whereas I only have to dig one wide if I go straight north and then dig one wide if I go straight east. So as it is right now, I'm going to turn around and I'm going to head back over here to where I came down initially, which was right here. And you can see the hole going all the way up there. It was minus 57 down below zero, and we were up about 70 on the top side. So I don't have enough wood frames. I'm going to have to make some more wood frames here real quick. So, whoops, that's not what I'm looking for, is it? Wood frame. There we go. Let's go ahead and make another. No, we don't need that many. Let's go ahead and make another 75, and we'll just let them start crafting. And that way, as I'm going up, they're going to be crafting. So we're going to have to go up this way and get out, and then this will allow us to come back down again when we come back in. Matter of fact, I need to get my map coordinates, because right now my map coordinates are 4442771, and I need to write that down. So bear with me just a second while I grab a piece of paper and go ahead and write those coordinates down. So we've got 4444 and 2771. All right, looks good. And now we can get out of this and we can continue to jump up and drop these as we go. Now, it's going to take a little while to get up there because we went a long way down, which I am hoping that what this will do is when the Zeds fall down, they will die immediately regardless, because it's over 100 frames all the way down. So that should come in handy. Ultimately, we will see. As it is, we're going to get back up to the top, and once we get back up to the top, we're going to head back over to the missile silo and figure out exactly what we want to handle over there. So, we Gotta be getting pretty close up here. I think it was like 70 up to the top. Let's see. We're at 65. Okay, here we go. Excellent. So it's 77 right here. So it's going to be over 80 going all the way up, which is fine. And let's see, we'll do it this way. And we'll continue to just kind of give ourselves some steps here. Go that way. Any Zeds? No. All right. That works. Okay, so we're going to head back over to the missile silo, and we will end up digging down from the missile silo and digging across. But we need to figure out where we want to do that at. I think we want to do it down at the bottom of the elevator where we're staying right now. We're going to go down there and take a look around, see what we can see. And I don't see any more Zeds over in this area, so... Alright, let's jump back up here and get this going. I am surprised. Alright, so... We want to make a door. We need to make a door. And we'll just go ahead and do the secure wood door for now. We'll craft it. And we've got no room for it, so let's get rid of that bone. We don't need it. Okay, that looks good. So, we are going to put the door there. That doesn't look right, does it? Well, it sure don't look right there. Yeah. Alright, we're going to go that route. Yes, that was what we wanted after all. Okay, that worked. Put the claw hammer down here. Alright, we need forged iron. So, we'll get some forged iron, some forged steel, and we'll upgrade it to a vault door, probably. But for the time being, it's fine. Okay, so, again, we're probably going to go all the way down to the bottom there. We need to take out the metal rail there, because it was in our way. Whoa. Really? Alright, that is not what I'm trying to do, guys. Alright, let's try this. Okay, that's better. That's better. Alright, so... I think this is right. Let's get our... I'm going to put some stone in here for now. Some clay. And we got some lead. That's fine. And we had a ladder. It's not... We're going to have to make another one, I'm sure. Because one is not going to be enough, I don't think, to get us where we want to be. Boom. There we go. I think I need one more. So we're going to go ahead and make it now. Ladder. Craft. There. That should be sufficient. So let's go ahead and do this. There. Now, what that will allow me to do is... I should be able to climb now. All the way down to the bottom. And I should be able to close this off. So... For the time being, I will close it off with wood blocks. And ultimately, I will close it off with concrete, obviously. But for the time being, we're going to do it with some wood blocks. So let's go ahead and close this up. Actually, we're going to do it this way. We're going to close this up with wood blocks. and we're going to create a door. And I know zombies like to go for doors, but it doesn't matter. This is not a big deal. Boom. There we go. Alright. That's fine. Not a big deal. Okay, so we've got that kind of closed off. I like it. And now we can go ahead and take this stuff out. And get rid of that. Wow, okay, so we can see through that. That's cool. See through that. It's concrete. It's not reinforced concrete, but it's still concrete. So that's not bad. And right now we're at plus 63. What's underneath here? Okay, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's 4 across. I guess I'm just going to have to pick one and go. Yeah, so we're going to pick the one over in this corner. And we're going to start... No, we're going to pick this one. Oh, wow. This is going to take a while. So we're going to have to go through a steel block. Then we're going to have to go through a concrete block. Then we're going to have to go through another concrete block. This is going to be fun. I'll tell you, if I can get everything upgraded to steel, I won't ever have to worry about these guys coming through. Wow. So this is 10,000 just for the steel block. And then once I make it through that, then I'm going to have concrete underneath it, I think. Well, I'll know in a moment. Yes, now we've got reinforced concrete, which is another 10,000. Or 6,000, rather. So it was 10,000 and 6,000. So 16,000 so far. And then we'll see what the actual concrete is underneath that. Not bad. What we'll do is we'll put a vault door here. Or a vault hatch, rather. Okay, another 3,000. So 19,000 is the hit points on it if it's upgraded all the way to steel. So not too bad. Not too shabby. Alright, I like it. I like it a lot. Okay, let's go ahead and get through this one. Let's see where this puts us. Be my luck, there'll be something underneath here and I'll just go... I'll fall and die or something. No. Okay, so good. We've got... Well, it doesn't matter. As long as we've got ladders, we can get back up out of here. Alright, but I do need to get up and take care of the... The pickaxe, get a new, get this one repaired, and then once I get out of that, all right, that looked good. Excellent. So, we need some forged steel. I like it. Forged steel it is. All right, so now we need to make a axe. We need to make a steel pickaxe, and it takes 20 for each one. And we might as well go ahead and make two of them, because we're going to be doing a lot of using the pickaxe down there to dig. All right, so let's go ahead and create another secure storage chest. We're going to need that, so we can just put some of our ore and things like that in the secure storage chest. So, alright, so let's see here. We'll do it there. We'll do it that way. This is where we're going to put the ore and the clay and the iron and the sand and all that stuff. And the lead. Alright, so let's go ahead and get the stuff over from this one. We need this. The brass, lead. Stone, clay. That clay. What else? More glass. Yeah, we can do the glass and more brass. And more lead. All right, we'll just have to come back over here for that in just a moment. All right, so let's put the stone away. Boom, boom. All right. Okay, looks good. And all right, so far so good. Okay, we got that stuff put away. We've got, what else do we have here that we need to deal with right now? We brought 101 forged steel with us, so we can make whatever we need to make later. And we can make more as we go along also. So we're good with that right now. We have anything else here that needs to go over in our materials locker? No, I think we're good on that right now. So let's go ahead and drop this stuff off real quick. Okay, and let's go ahead and get... In this one, we want raw iron and more clay. Because that's how we roll. And tomorrow, I'm going to make a trip back over to our other base and get a whole lot of concrete and bring it back with me because we're going to need it. All right, so let's go ahead and do this. All right, that's 12 minutes, 18 minutes. That shouldn't attract anything. And if it does, I'll just have to deal with it. All right. And let's do that. Yeah, I can deal with that. In the meantime, though, let's go ahead and just do this down here. I know you're probably wondering what the method is to my madness here. You'll see in just a moment. Alright, so if we do this and we put just ones in there, and we put this stone back over in our inventory over here. Now if I shift-click it, it'll go on top of these that are already there. So that makes it a little easier to manage it and just make it sit a little nicer there. Do it that way. And there we go. And the crushed sand we're gonna just do like this. Good. And we need to make another forge. So alright, so let's see, where were we? I had to step away for a second there. All right, let's go see what we got here. We do have a pickaxe already, so let's go ahead and fix this one. So now we have a pickaxe that we can use when we go downstairs here in just a moment. We also want to, as I said, dig down to bedrock. Now, if you look at your map, earlier we said that we were 4444 and 2771, so all we have to do is go over here to 2771. That doesn't look right. That does not look right at all, does it? Because I know I was on this side of that. Did I write those coordinates down wrong a while ago? Oh well, probably did. Okay, in the meantime, let's check real quick and see if we've got some animal hide. We do not have, well, actually we do have enough. We're going to take these. We're going to take this. We're going to recipes, leather, and craft all of them. And so we want to make another bellows. And we'll go ahead and do that right now. And then for us to make a forge, we need a bellows, short iron pipe, lump of clay, and stone. 50 and 50. So we need 50 of this. Alright, so... Okay, that gives us 50 of that. And we need 50 stone. Alright, that's going to be fun. Alright, we'll just do it that way. Forge. There's the bellows. That's what we needed. And we'll craft that. Okay, good. Let's put the stone back. Let's put the pipe and the leather back. Those are good. Alright. Let's see what else we got here. Okay, we've got... What do I want to do here? Alright, we've got our pickaxe, our steel pickaxe, which is going to get us down to bedrock. In the meantime, we need to start another forge. And what we want to do is we want to put... We're going to put stone in this one. We're just going to fill it up with stone right now. And yes, I know I got a buttload of this over at the other site, and I'm going to go back over there in the morning after daylight and get some of it. But right now, we don't really want to do too much there. Alright, let's go that route. Now, I'll probably end up getting a screamer or something, but as it is, I'm not going to worry about it too much. Not going to worry about it too much. If I get one, I get one. Alright, so what do we have? We have the pickaxe, and that's what we need to get down in the hole with. So we are going to head down into the hole. Alright. Okay, guys. Now, what I generally try and do is I try and generally just dig straight down. I'll get a few. Alright, get a few levels down. Then I'll normally take my frames and I will put my frame up top there just to kind of protect myself from on top. And then I'll start digging down again. So, as it is, again, I will see you guys when I get down to bedrock again. So, be back in a minute. Alright guys, I have made it down to bedrock. As you can see, I had just dug straight down, so again, that would have just been boring to sit here. Even on time lapse, that would be boring to sit here and watch me do that. What we have to do now is we have to look at the map, and so we need to go due west, and I'm thinking if I get it to be, let's put a quick waypoint there. So if I get it to be about right, let's see, 2771, I'm at 2741 now. So if I go west until I get to 2771, let's see where that's at, okay? Okay, so I'm going to head west, I'm going to head due west, and we're just going to kind of knock it out here, see what we get. Alright, so we're going to go straight west until we get 2771, and then we're going to see what that comes out to be. And hopefully, it'll work out the way I had it planned. Alright, so we're going to kind of lean ourselves up until we can get as high as we can above us, and we're gonna come back and just kind of clean this out. We want to make sure this is nice and clean here. All right, looks good. I like it. All right, just a little further. Okay, good. I like it. Alright, so we're going to get over to 2771. We're not there yet. We will see where we're at here in just a minute. Hopefully it won't be too far over. We'll see how it looks when we get there. And see what I mean about how just, you know, watching me mine, just going through, even if this short distance that I'm doing right now, I mean, it can get very boring, and normally I would time-lapse this, and again, I may actually time-lapse this, and you won't hear any of this stuff that I'm saying right now, but we'll see. Looking good. Let's see where this is. Alright, looks good. Let's get a little bit further. Alright. Alright, let's look at the map again. Okay, so this time we are at 2755. And we are on our way over to... Okay, so 2755. 65... So let's go ahead and get another 10 blocks over and see where we're at. So, we'll go ahead and do it this way. Alright, so, 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, and 3. Just knock our way through here. We'll do another 3 here. Okay, looks good. 2. I'll tell you what, if you're trying to do this with a stone axe, this takes forever. So once you get up to steel pickaxes, it works a lot faster. They did change up something in this latest version, in the 15 version. In that you can no longer one-shot, even at the highest skill level, you can no longer one-shot the rock. Now, you can do it if you're using like a Valmod mod, but you can't do it in the vanilla game anymore, which I kind of find a little bit of a bummer, but oh well. I guess they had to make it a little more difficult for us to mine this stuff out, but what it means is that it takes twice as long now to mine something than it used to be when you had max skills. But, oh well, it is what it is. We just we'll make it work. We will, because that's what we do. We're miners in a diggy diggy hole down here. All right, so we're getting close, and let's go ahead and take this out. All right, now let's check and see where we're at on the map. 2767. So let's go forward another 4. Okay. We'll see if this works. Not certain, but we'll find out. Alright. Not bad. Alright, looking good. It's also nice when you get to this point where you can work through the night underground and you don't have to worry about the Zeds. They're not an issue for you because you've kind of got it all worked out at this point. And we are at 2771. So we should be able to turn south now. So we're going to turn south and we're going to see if this map actually works for us that way. So we're going to go due south. I wonder if I can finish this up in one night. If I can make these connect. If I can, this is going to be a trip. Alright, let's see if we're still at 2771. All right, let's see if we're still at 2771 now. Yes, we are. Okay, so we're at 2771. We're heading due south. We're going to see if we can meet up with the one that we've already started down there. May not be able to do it through the night, but we will find out. We are going to have to go back and eat here in a little while, but we've still got plenty right now. It's not a big deal. All right, looking good. I like it. I probably should put a bedroll down over here so that if I do die, I don't wake up over at the other base far away from all of my stuff. So I might do that before I head out in the morning. We'll see. Alright guys, I'll time lapse this, so we'll see you in just a little bit. Okay guys, we are back. Let's take a look and see where we're at on the map. Oh, we are getting pretty close. We still have a little ways to go. I think we were about right here maybe before. So we do have a little ways to go. We're not going to do it right now. We're going to head back up topside. I need to see where we're at time-wise on this episode. But let's head back up top and check on our forges and get our mini bike ready to go over to the other location. So let's head back over here to the end of this tunnel, and you will see that we have actually dug quite a bit here. That is not bad. That is not bad at all. So we'll turn and head over to this way. Okay, now let's head back up. We need to make some more wood frames. And let's make 100. Craft them. Alright, so let's go ahead and head up. And I will see you guys at the top. Alright, we have made it back up here. And let's check on our forges. Excuse me. Something stuck in my throat there. And this forge needs to be reloaded up, and we are going to load this one up. 19? No, we're going to load this one up with 30. Yeah, we're going to go ahead and give it 30 minutes and turn it on. And we're going to do the same thing with this one over here. I'm going to give it 30 minutes as well. Okay. That wasn't yet. Alright, that wasn't what we wanted to do. Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright, there we go. We'll turn that on. Let it keep going. Alright, so we've got those going again, and we're going to check our time. And it looks like our time is about up. So the Golden Dragon is heading back to the area. If you enjoyed this episode, please hit the like button. If you like my content, you're new to my channel, and you haven't had a chance to subscribe yet, please feel free to do so. Your subscriptions let me know that you enjoy what I do, and I do love what I do. For now, so long, and fly safe.